Jessica Mauboy. Oh, I just love her, and she's about to do Australia proud on the world stage once again. She's getting ready to sing for us at this year's Eurovision Song Contest, and Angela Bishop sat down with her before the big trip to Portugal for this year's event.
Jessica Mauboy, it is not long till you get on a plane and head over. How are you feeling?
I'm a bit anxious now. I've got 2 weeks prior to the actual event beginning, so butterflies are at its effect at the moment.
Tell me about the dress. What can you tell me? Who's made it?
Well, I've been working with my stylist, Mikey AUB, and he's just, you know, he's one of my greatest friends, and I love collaborating with him, and I'm calling it my Dreamtime dress.
Beautiful.
It's definitely a story that I've, you know, been able to translate, you know, through these fabrics and materials, and hopefully I can really take my energy, the dress, the song to another level once we hit the stage.
Please welcome to the stage from Darwin, Australia, Miss Jessica Mauboy.
You've got, I guess, a bit of an advantage from certainly the other Australians that have gone over, in that you've performed there.
Being invited in 2014 as an interval act was beyond my imagination and my vision of where I wanted to go musically. It was a moment, and you know, like, I still have it in my body, and yes, it is an advantage. Like, I can really take that, really place it into my next performance that I'll be, you know, gracing the stage 2018 Eurovision Song Contest, you know, singing another song that I've written. So don't give up,
'cause we got love, 'cause we got love. You're similar to someone representing Australia in the Olympics or the Commonwealth Games. This is the arts equivalent, if you like. Do you see that sort of comparison, if I make it like that?
It is similar to the Olympics. You know, we're training for months and months. The idea is really creating in the mind to be able to then physically get it prepared. I've been doing a routine, a dance performance for the last month or so. Every day has been, you know, for 4 or 5 hours training. So there's a lot of things to think about, and it is the music Olympics.
It is. I reckon it is, 100%. You're beautiful, beautiful, you're beautiful, you're beautiful, beautiful. So who's Team Jess? Who are you going to have there supporting you? Who's in?
My core team that I'm taking over to Lisbon would be my manager, a makeup artist who's a dear friend, a choreographer who's a really dear friend, my partner family, and everybody else I'll be taking in spirit, in my soul and in my heart. And I'm just, yeah, I think keeping it really tight.
What do you want us to do when we're watching on the TV at home? We've got a little cheer you want us to do, or, you know?
I have this move that's a part of my dance routine.
Okay.
It's when the chorus hits the lyrics, "We got love." 'Cause we got love, 'cause we got love.
We can do that.
It's to the heart.
'Cause we got love.
To you, to the heart above, and whatever you believe in, that's
easier than the Rocky Horror dance. We can do that. So we'll sit in front of the telly doing it with you.
We got love.
That'll be fantastic.
Yeah.
And we have a new winner of the Eurovision Song Contest 2016. It's Ukraine!
If you win, does it come to Australia?
It's a really, really hard one, isn't it, to answer, because we just never know. And I think it says it all by Australia being involved and competing. So we never know where this may take us. And it could, and I don't know how that would happen, but a country, you know, our country would have to come together and make that decision together.
Here we are in South-South Western Europe.
Right.
South-South-West Europe.
But in the mind, I'm just thinking what Eurovision board would be thinking.
Let's make it a problem we have to have.
Why do we always feel like we need to try?
You turn 30?
When?
Next year.
Next year. Because you were born the same year I started at Channel 10. Wow. I'll just give you that.
There you go.
So I clock up 30 years at Channel 10 next year when you turn 30. Any goals for your 30th?
I genuinely want to still be able to move and travel and take myself to places I've never ever seen before, never imagined going with my music.
World domination.
World domination would be perfect.
She just lights up the screen, doesn't she? And Ange went out to do Jess Mauboy yesterday because she's got this dreaded lurgy that everyone's battling here at Channel 10. And she's like, oh, my God, I need to wear a mask to go and talk to Jessica Mauboy because if I infect her before Eurovision...
That's right.
I'll be strung up and hung and drawn and quartered.
Angela Bishop, the woman who cost Australia Eurovision. Finally, Australia would no longer be a part of Europe.
But, yeah, she's so beautiful, Jessica Mauboy.
And down to earth.
She's such a good role model.
Oh, lovely.